All right, welcome back to Rocket Restoration's World Headquarters with a big random silo in the background of my farm. Just wanted to do an interesting video today. Want to kind of do a little compare and contrast. I did a video on another Barracuda we picked up last week, but I want to do a video on what the differences are between a 64 and 65 Plymouth Barracuda. A little history behind. For those who don't know, the Barracuda did beat the Mustang to market by, I think it was 16 days. Obviously, Barracuda won the battle, but I don't think there's any argument for anybody that the Mustang won the war. You know, Mustang sold 500,000 cars in a year and a half, and Barracuda sold, like, I don't know what the production numbers are, but it was significantly less. But I just wanted to highlight, you know, the 64 and a half Barracuda came out. I just wanted to highlight what the differences are between a 64 and a 65. So there's not a ton of examples on this one. Unfortunately, the emblem's missing. But one of the big ones is there's supposed to be a Barracuda emblem right here. And on a 64, it has a long tail on it, and it's a short one on the other one. Here, I'll show you on the other car. So here's the other Barracuda we got from the super secret estate sale. But you can see right here has a short tail. On a 64 and a half, the tail goes out about that far. Okay, so a couple of the changes they did. This one's not a great example of that because it was a floor shift auto, but in 64 they had a push button, so the push button stuff was right here. And then in 65, if you had a column auto, or if you had automatic, it went to the 3 on the column. Or if, you know, the floor shift stayed the same. It was floor shift to floor shift. And 65 is still cable shift. 66, they went to linkage, but 65 was still cable shift. And then if you had an automatic, it went to a slip yoke drive shaft. And if you had a 4-speed, it was still ball and trunnion. All 64s were ball and trunnion. So they had the rubber on the front of the drive shaft that, ball and trunnion, but it's not a great design, but they work. The other big difference is the dash changed. So on a 65, it has two big binnacles with the all three gauges in there. And on 64, it was three individual gauges on the right there. So, but yeah, this car is actually pretty solid. It was sitting out in the weeds forever, but it's pretty complete and solid. It's missing the front turn signals and some of the exterior trim, but really most of it's here and most of it's in pretty good shape. So the other big difference is in 64 it was a Valiant Barracuda, which is the worst marketing campaign ever. You don't want to take your pedestrian economy car, or, you know, and make it and as the same name as your new sporty fastback. So but on 64s they had a Valiant emblem right here, and there'd be three holes there. Even if the emblem's gone, there'd be three holes there. So that's the big difference. But the Barracuda was definitely an interesting car. This one's got quite a few options, has the bumper guards. These had the biggest back window ever made up to this point. Just a huge greenhouse back here. And it's, you know, kind of an urban legend that, you know, one of the dumb reality shows out there, oh my God, we're going to lose our shop unless we fix this window. You know, they broke one on purpose. And they said these are hard to find. These are not hard to find. Like, they're actually really, really tough. The curved design makes them almost impossible to break. I had a buddy one time who had like four of them and literally threw them away at the dump. And he was throwing scrap on top of it for 5 minutes, like literally throwing metal brake drums, control arms, all that kind of stuff on top of that window. And it never broke. Like, they're actually, I mean, it's glass, they'll break, but they're not that hard to find. Barracuda is a pretty neat car. You know, it was the sporty new model from Chrysler. You know, the Valiant was the boring one. This is their response to the Mustang, and they beat it in the market, but we all know, kind of know how that goes. But the really nice bonus about this car, I didn't realize this when I bought it, we got it up on the trailer, but it has a Mopar A-body 8 3/4 in it. So all of these came with 7 1/4 rear ends, no matter what motor you got. That was the cheap one. They're not very strong. They're not very tough. It wasn't until 66 that the A-body got the 8 3/4 because Chrysler was having too many warranty claims. So on a V8 4-speed car in 66, about halfway through the year, they started to put 8 3/4 in them. But this is a real nice bonus. That's a very, very hard to find rear end. So it's a nice bonus that this has it. It even has the drive shaft in the trunk for it, which is really neat. As you can see, this, it's actually a pretty good size hitch on this thing. I mean, it's not much of a tongue on it, but like, that's like a pretty good size hitch on this thing. It's not just, I mean, it's actually welded on into the frame rail. And a lot of these are just like two bolts to like tow a couple hundred pound boat. Like this one's actually pretty solid. I should just put an engine in this and start towing stuff with it. That would be entertaining. It's got one chrome reverse, 13 inch, tiny little thing. Yeah, unfortunately, it's missing the turn signals, but pretty much everything else is here. It's missing the Plymouth emblem for that and the latch too, but that's not a huge deal. It's got the radiator. These are getting pretty hard to find. Any A-body radiator is pretty hard to find anymore. But again, it's just a really solid car. Like there's just no major rust on it. You know, it's got on an A-body with a V8. So see that drag link there, how it goes way down? That was V8 only to clear the pan. So that's a V8. That's a hard piece to find. Manual steering. It was originally a V8 car. You can tell the different cane members because the holes of the mounts are symmetrical. On a slant 6 car, they're a little bit back. Here, I'll show you on the other 65 here. So this is our other 65. Well, maybe this was a V8 car. I don't know. Maybe I'm just totally wrong about this. I know on the 67 and up, it's different, but the holes are... See, I think that one's symmetrical. I don't know. If I'm wrong, everybody tell me in the comments. Everybody usually does anyways. But this was a slant 6 car originally. So that's a slant 6 key member and they're different. So, but yeah, I believe the difference is they're symmetrical on a V8 and then they're offset on a slant 6. Yeah, this one has the tunnel ram edition Barracuda hood where it's just cut out with a sawzall. Yeah, I'm pretty sure Jamie has a dual quad small block intake tunnel ram. That would look really good on this thing. Another difference between 64 and 65 too is the windshield wipers. So in 65, they just slid on with a clip. 64, they actually had a nut on them. So there's another difference. So there's a lot of little differences, but I'm just trying to kind of highlight most of the major stuff here. So, all right, well, it's actually not raining here for once, which is pretty unusual this time of year. So I'm going to go unload this thing and it's going to sit back and row back here. Not quite sure what I'm going to do with this one. We keep on talking about doing our Lemons build, but I've already built the Lemons Barracuda and it's kind of been done. But yeah, I don't know. Baby's looking for a nice project. This one's pretty nice. So, all right. Thanks for listening. And we'll talk to you guys all soon.